Welcome to the Productive Co. YouTube channel. In this video, we're taking a tour of Dubsado. Hi, my name is Ray and I run Productive Co. I help small business owners use Dubsado so that they can have an awesome client management system that saves them time and money and impresses their clients all at the same time. If you want more tips on Dubsado, make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel and then hit the bell icon to get notifications for when new videos go live. Without further ado, let's take a tour. When you log into Dubsado, the first thing you're going to see is your dashboard. And here on the upper left, you can set a financial goal for yourself. Then there's open invoices. This shows you invoices that you've sent out but haven't been paid yet. You can also see how your revenue compares this month to last month. And in recent, you'll be able to see if there are any missed payments on invoices, if there are any contracts you need to countersign, and any release notes from Dubsado. If you hook up your calendar, you can sort your calendar by a overview, monthly or weekly view. And then there's a financial section. You can choose different time periods that you want to compare and see how your finances in one time period compared to another. You can also add tasks. Just so you know, Dubsado has a search bar here at the top. So if you ever need to find anything, you can just utilize the search bar. This envelope icon here is your inbox. You'll be able to see any emails that you haven't read yet. The bell icon is the notifications icon. So if anybody completes a task, that will pop up in the notifications icon. The question mark icon is where you can access help from Dubsado. And the cog wheel is where your basic settings are. The tabs that you have access to will be on the left side. So we've already gone over dashboard. The next one is projects. This is where all of your work will live. So you can have leads who are prospective clients be separate from jobs who are paying clients. You can actually create statuses inside of leads and statuses inside of jobs. So you can monitor someone's progress through a funnel. And I have one person in leads and that's who's come up right here. If I click on their name, I'm transported to their folder. This houses all of their information. Projects also has this really cool feature for tagging. So in order to create tags, you would hit customize. Go down to the bottom, you can add different tags. So you could put something like logo design and choose the color that you want it to be. Accounting is where your general bookkeeping goes. Calendar, if you just want to take a look at your calendar. Tasks, this is where your project management is housed. So you can view just your tasks. All tasks, if you're on a team, you might want to see somebody else's tasks. And this shows it in a list view. And then you can create boards, which shows it more in a Trello-like view. So this is one board here. So I'll just click it and open. And I've created a couple different columns and I have a card here. So I can drag that card wherever I want and I can check it off when I'm done. Utilities. This will show you a list of any form you've ever sent. The address book will pull all jobs and clients' information into the address book. Then there's the time tracker. You can actually type in what kind of task you're working on and what job it belongs to, and then what your rate is. The great thing about this is that you can actually have it automatically apply to an invoice. So that way you'll never have to keep track of what time you've billed and what time you haven't billed. And then there's this phenomenal template section. The template section allows you to save a lot of time because you upload templates to it and then you make copies of those templates and you use them for different clients. You can edit them from there, but this is where your templates live. There's a scheduling button, a form button where you upload all different types of documents, so contracts, sub-agreements, questionnaires, proposals, And then that lead capture, which is essentially your contact form. And there's canned emails. Then there's packages. Packages are the services that you sell with descriptions and a price. So this is what would appear on an invoice. So instead of having to manually type in every single line item every time, one package here that would be a branding and include all the details in branding and then just apply that one package to an invoice. Then there's payment schedules. So whenever you send out an invoice, I recommend that you send a payment schedule with it, and this will create a due date or a payment plan on your invoices. And then you can combine all of these different elements into workflows. So workflows are your automation feature. They're the backbone of Dubsado. You essentially take these other template elements here, plus a couple other things, and you add them into the workflow. If you have multiple services, you'll likely have multiple workflows. This one here is for hand lettering, and you can just add actions here. So this will tell Dubsado what actions to trigger, so that you don't have to do it yourself. It can do a lot of things to save you time. So this is what makes Dubsado so amazing, is that it's essentially a virtual assistant, so that you can get more done without having to do more. Dubsado will take over a lot of your tasks for you. That's the Dubsado interface in a nutshell. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to pop them down in the comments below. If you found this video helpful in any way, shape, or form, go ahead and hit the like button so that I know to make more videos just like this one. If you want more information on Dubsado, be sure to head over to my website, productiveco.com, where you can find articles and free downloads on how to use Dubsado. Thanks for joining me today. I'll see you around.